Hey friends, for this week's media demonstration video, we're going to be using crayons and watercolor paint to finish this really cute drawing of a cat and a pumpkin. As you can see, the cat's holding a sign that says Give Thanks 2021. This is an example of a really cute sort of a Thanksgiving time lesson. And it's nice because it's not exactly a turkey, but it's still kind of cool. So anyway, I hope you enjoy it. You can always color these with whatever supplies you have. This lesson is great in any material, but I'm going to do crayons and watercolor paint today. That's one of my favorite combinations, and I'm going to go ahead and just do this in time lapse. You probably know how to use crayons and paint, but I'm going to demonstrate, and I hope you enjoy it. Here we go. That was a lot of work, but boy, it's so cute. And I say that a lot, I know I do, but really it's worth it, guys. Your hard work pays off. It's something you'll have to enjoy forever. And it's something, you know what, if you want to, you can give it away as a gift to someone that you care about. And those things mean a lot to people and makes them really, really happy. So as you can see, I broke quite a few crayons as I was coloring. That is really just the way it goes. It's okay. That's what they're for. But you can, you know, use these literally till they disappear. That's one of the really nice things about using art supplies. You don't need them to be brand new. They will work until they disappear. And I think that's really a good thing. So now it's time to do the watercolor paint. And so I'm going to get started with that in a second. But before I do, I want to talk about the pressure of the crayon coloring. So I've seen my students do this quite a few times, and I know they're smaller than I am and younger, but guys, you have to color really hard. You have to color like you mean it. Can you see how thick this crayon is here? And do you notice how I didn't do the background, right? So I'm going to show you how to do that in just a second. But wherever you put the crayon, you need to color really thick, like really heavy. Color like you mean it. If you color like this, it's just not going to work, guys. This is not going to work very well. What you need to do is press down like this. You got to really bear down. You want this super duper rich colors. Remember, if you're doing it lightly, it's not enough. So if you have to practice on free dry paper to get that pressure right, that's okay. That's a fine thing. Because what you need is the wax and the crayon to really be on the paper so that it resists the water and the paint. That's what we're doing. We're doing wax resist. So before I do the paint, I want to mention, guys, I seem to forget this about half the time, put your name on the back. It never hurts to put the date, right? This is the date that I'm doing this. And that way I'll always, always remember. Now the date is on the front, I know. Some people like to put their name on the front, that's fine too. But it really helps to put your name somewhere on the back. And anyway, now I'm ready to paint. So there are lots of paint brushes in the world. I wanted to show you small, medium, and large. If we were only doing paint today, I'd say use the small and the medium, but for this technique, you need a nice broad flat brush. And so I've got my paint ready. This is the lid. This is actually a mixing tray. I've got a paper towel. I've got my cup of water. And because I have so many oranges and yellows, I definitely want like a bluish, purplish kind of sky. So what I'm doing is I'm taking the water and I'm loading it up into my paint tray. This is something I see a lot of kids do. They don't quite realize you gotta have a lot of water to make watercolor paint. So go ahead and fill it up in there. I'm also gonna take some water and I'm gonna start doing that to my purple also. And so there's a lot of ways you can do the same thing, guys, but this is a really great way to make sure that your paint is filling up and that you have plenty of it. Now you can use your mixing tray. If you don't want to use your mixing tray because there's already colors there, I'm gonna show you what to do. You see how I'm adding water and I'm stirring it that way when I take my paper towel and I get that color off my mixing tray. I am preparing it. See that It's not going to be in my blue and purple now. I'm preparing it for my lovely blue and purple. So now that I've gotten plenty of water in there, look at all that paint that I have. And straight blue is lovely. It is. It's nice. I can't say it's not, but it's also just one thing. It's not really a mixture. So you can also try straight purple also. Perfectly nice. But honestly, guys, I hope you're going to try to do some color blending. Use your mixing tray the way it's meant to be used to mix the colors. All right. Well, I'm a huge fan of bluish purple. I think I've done this one a bunch, but you can make your sky any color at all. It could be green. It could be orange. But I'm choosing this color because it's going to contrast really well. So, all right, guys, I'm going to start. So the other thing is people are like, oh, I've got to go all the way around. Well, you know what? That's not true. Not with Wax Resist. You go right over the top. And so do you see what I'm doing? You don't have to even be very careful. Look, I'm going over my cat's face. I'm going over my cat's chest. I'm going over the leaves. You guys see what I'm doing? I'm not going around. I'm going over. And that's because, I'm going right over my pumpkin, by the way. And that's because the paint is being resisted. Resisted. Do you know what that word means? I hope you do. By the paint. So the wax is resisting the paint, is what I'm trying to say. And people don't seem to get this for some reason, but please get it. You can change colors. You don't have to do the whole thing in the same color. You see how I'm going over the cat, over the leaves. I'm going up and down and up and down and up and down. And you can see that it's everywhere, right? What makes this so cool is you're gonna take your paper towel and you're just gonna start to gently blot. See how I'm blotting it? I'm not rubbing it. I'm blotting it. I'm going straight up and straight down. And I am lifting that color. And wherever it is on the crayon, it's not gonna stick. But you can see how nice it is because it goes through. There's little spots. Wherever there is no crayon, it goes through. And that's what makes this so pretty and so special. So it's also really easy. It's fun. You can do it over and over again. And this looks good because blue and orange are complementary colors. They look great side by side. So friends, that's how you do it. I hope you're going to give it a whirl. It's a super fun lesson. And I'm giving a lot of thanks this year for you guys. You've all been really wonderful to work with. And that's it for today, guys. See you next time.